Now, documents accessed by your channel show how a steel ministry consultant, Ajit Jha, is facing case of impersonation. He was appointed as a consultant to the ministry, MOS Steel, Vishnu Deo, in October 31st. But this bureaucrat has been using a letterhead of additional secretary to the MOS Steel for official communication. Take a look at the report.
This is Ajit Kumar Jha, a consultant in the Ministry of Steel, drawing a salary of 60,000 rupees, according to his letter available with Times Now. But what makes this man, Ajit Kumar Jha, dubious is the fact that he's been masquerading as the Minister of State for Steel, Vishnu Deo Sahai's additional private secretary, as late as January 2015. Even though he ceased to hold this position in October last year.
According to these documents, Ajit Kumar Jha calls himself as the additional private secretary to the Minister of State for Steel, Vishnu Deo Sahai.
And just what are these favours that he is seeking? To requisition for hospital beds and railway confirmation using the minister's name. He was appointed consultant in October last year. But he impersonates himself as the minister's APS to seek hospital beds and even for seeking railway confirmations. Ajit Kumar Jha ceased to be additional private secretary to the MOS on October 31st. Something he confirms on the candid camera.
आपने कितने लेटर्स लिखे हैं?
मुश्किल से 4-5 लिखे हैं, बहुत टॉप ऑर्डिनेट था तब.
तो मिनिस्टर ने आपको क्या कहा है जब आप
बोले जाइए सर?
मिनिस्टर को ये कब पता चला?
तो महीना पहले पता चला, उन्होंने कहा यानी ऐसी चीज़ पता है कैसा क्या है क्या मुझे बोला सर अर्जेंट के मैंने ऐसा पुराने लेटर थे उसको मैंने लिख दिया और बोला नहीं अब तो नहीं होना चाहिए.
But what is shocking is that the minister and his staff knew about the masquerade and have done precious little to report him to the authorities.
He was doing it earlier, so he just got carried away, I'm saying. That is what I'm saying. You have to distinguish. It is not that he is totally imposter, he has come from totally outside from somewhere. Try to understand that he is not a person who was not linked with the office, with the minister at all.
It's not surprising that Ajit Kumar Jha is called as a chosen one of the minister in the steel ministry. Let off with just a warning when this matter of impropriety and illegal activity was brought to the notice of the steel minister.
देखिए शुरू में वो थे एडिशनल पीएस के रूप में उनकी नियुक्ति हुई थी, लेकिन जब एक आया कि जो यूपीए गवर्नमेंट में जो काम कर चुके हैं उनको एनडीए गवर्नमेंट में मतलब नहीं रखना है, तब से हमारे पास वो विधिवत नियुक्ति नहीं है. उनको कहा, थोड़ा पता चला था हमको, तो हमने उनको डांटा भी.
इवन इफ एज द मिनिस्टर क्लेम्स दैट झा वाज एन एडिशनल सेक्रेटरी अर्लियर, द फैक्ट इज दैट हिज लेटेस्ट अपॉइंटमेंट लेटर क्लियरली स्टेट्स हिज रोल ओनली एज अ कंसल्टेंट. सो इज अ वार्निंग इनफ or should the minister have reported the impersonator to the authorities? After all, his own staff does confirm the proximity of Ajit Kumar Jha to the minister himself.
Knowing a minister, he goes and meet the minister, suppose once in a week, once in a fortnight. आप रोक सकते हैं क्या किसी को? Somebody, especially lower staff who has seen him coming more frequently and now he's becoming slightly less frequent.
At a time when Prime Minister Narendra Modi has set stiff norms for ministers' personal staff, is impersonation not a serious enough offence for action? It's a question that begs an answer.